This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. What up, you guys? It's Janik here for CineCam.net and welcome to Copycat Friday. It's a series where we recreate effects from famous movies and music videos. And today we are recreating the door transition from Just 2, Focus on Me. Hello guys, I'm back again to host this week's Copycat Friday. And like you saw in the intro, we are recreating a very cool transition effect. When searching for a new idea, we came across a new K-pop sensation, Just 2. Of course we know it's just JB and Yugyeom from GOT7. Do you pronounce it like that? Anyways, but still, their new music video with Just 2 is pretty awesome and full with effects. We really had a hard time choosing a certain effect from it, as it has glitches, multiple transitions and freeze effects. But the one that has the most effect on us and on the music video clip was the endless door transition. That's why we decided to recreate it for you guys, but what's a copycat recreation without an awesome set?
Over the past months, guys, we've been working super hard in our studio to give it a huge upgrade. For example, we've hanged all of these lights to the ceiling on truss, and we're going to make a video about that very soon, by the way. But we've also created these walls, which we can use to build sets. Now, currently, we've created a big room, as you can see behind me, and we're going to move this wall right here, the right one, more to the left, so that way that the door can become in the middle and so that we have a more symmetrical hallway.
Okay, like you can see from our cool set, you're going to need a hallway with a door in the middle. It can also be a large room. Just make sure you have a door that leads to a place with some space, because there you need to set up a green screen. We are going to place it behind our set so that you can see the green through the door. Of course, you can all do this at your own home. This set is just because we don't have a hallway in our office.
So, all set up. Oh no! We're currently in a snow landscape. Oh, what's that? We're now in the desert. Oh no, we're now in the forest. Oh no, that were just some stock clips from Storyblocks Video, our sponsor today, where you can find high quality 4K stock clips. You can find After Effects templates, logo animations, transitions, video effects, flares, muzzle effects, and so much more. And the cool thing is that you only need to pay a single price per year, and with that, you can download the entire library if you like so. Definitely make sure to check it out yourself. It's a really cool library that we use very often here on the channel, and you can do so by clicking the first link in the description below.
Now that the green screen is placed, we are going to talk about lighting it. Or better, Jordi is going to talk about it.
These right here are actually some very old DIY lights that I've created in the past. These are just simply fluorescent tubes and are the Philips Graphica, which have a better lighting quality to them. Just a simple fluorescent fixture around them, and that's it. I've mounted it to a normal light stand. And because they are long, it is perfect to light out green screens. It's also very soft lighting, so that is perfect. Now, the green screen behind the door should not only cover the background, but also the floor. That is going to give you a little bit of a problem with the transition between the green screen and the actual scene right here. Now, we've seen in the past that we can solve this through a wire removal inside After Effects or by creating and tracking extra masks, but you're just going to make it more complicated for yourself. So the easiest solution is just by adding some kind of a tape or by adding a sort of a doorstep to your scene. Just make sure that with whatever you add in here on top of that green screen, that it seems to be part of your scene, and that way nobody will notice it.
So I think our set is done now. Let's have a look at the camera movement. This is a movement from the front to the back at a constant speed. In the original clip from Just 2, they probably used a motion-controlled dolly to achieve this. But we don't have that kind of gear, and we want to make it accessible for everyone. That's why we used a gimbal and tried to walk at a constant speed for every shot. Of course, it's nearly impossible to walk at the same speed over and over again, but we have a solution for that in post-production. Now let's make these shots. For the first shot and the beginning of your effect, you can film wherever you want. We, for example, took our shot in the parking of our studio. What you need to do is film while you walk backwards. Then your actor can come in and do its thing. Just keep walking backwards for a while until you have enough bleed. For the second shot in the hallway, you start very close to the green screen. In fact, it should be the only thing visible in your shot. Then again, you start walking backwards until you can't no more. But keep in mind that you still need some bleed to make the effect work. It's not always necessary, but better to be safe than sorry. And before I forget, you need two tracking marks. we placed it on the doorpost on top, because this is the first thing you see after the green screen while moving backwards. But keep in mind that your actor can't cover these tracking points, otherwise it will make the tracking in post-production a lot harder. Now you can shoot this in multiple different hallways or with different actors. When you have so much variation in the scene and actors, it will enhance the effect. Okay, we have everything for the effect. Now let's dive into After Effects. First, create a new composition and place the first shot in this comp. You can already scale it up to 120% in the effects controls. This will make it easier further on. Now it's time for the second shot, the one with the hallway. Place this shot on top and let it start somewhere in the middle of the first shot. It can also start earlier or later, but just make sure the first shot, its movement is long enough to cover a large part of the second shot. Now let's remove the green. Go to the effects library and search for the key light effect. Drag it to your layer and in the effects controls, take the color selector. Use this to select the green within the door. If the key doesn't work too great, you can always adjust it in the settings within the effects controls. Just keep tweaking until you get it right.
Now guys, if you're still having trouble pulling off your green key, well, I came across a pretty cool solution. We're going to work together with BorisFX very soon on the channel, and one of their plugins is called PrimeMat Studio. Now, PrimeMat also works inside Premiere Pro, and it is built upon a similar technology that Hollywood productions use. Very quick, what can you do with it? Just select what you want to remove with one click, and then you can further tweak what your green screen is by selecting it and also what your foreground is. Now, pretty cool is that, for example, here on the bottom, we've got a huge reflection of that green screen, but with this plugin, I can simply select that foreground and say, this is part of my foreground scene. Look how cool that is. Now, they're not sponsoring this episode right here today. I just really wanted to show you guys this because I think it's really awesome. And I want you guys to know that this is out there. I'll make sure to leave a link to this plugin in the description below.
Okay, now you have two shots on top of each other, both with movement backwards. But you can see that the movement doesn't match when the floor from the second clip comes in. So now we are going to fix that with the tracker. Go to the tracker panel on the right. If you can't find it, just go to the top, to window, and search between the options. Okay, now that you have the tracker panel, click on the track motion and enable the position and the scale. This will give you two trackers, which you can place over the tracking points we placed on the doorpost. The inner square of the trackers can be small, just big enough to enclose the point. This will tell After Effects that this is the point to follow. The outer square of the trackers needs to be bigger. This is the search area After Effects is going to use. Now that the trackers are in place, you can click on Analyze Forward. Let After Effects do its thing, but keep an eye on it so you can intervene when the tracking goes wrong. After it's done, go up to Layer, New, and select Null Object. This will create a null object which we are going to use with the tracking. Again, select the layer you were tracking and go back to the tracker panel. Under the Motion Target, you can press Edit Target and then select the null object. Now you can press Apply and then OK. This will give the null object all the keyframes After Effects made while doing the tracking. The next step is using this tracking data. Search for the point in your second clip where the floor becomes visible. Now select the first clip and make a cut here. You can do this by pressing the shortcut Ctrl+Shift+D. This will create a cut onto a new layer. Select this and right-click on it. Go to Time and press Freeze Frame. This will do exactly as it says. Freeze the frame. Go to the Parent Pick Whip tool and parent it with the null object. Now the two are connected and the freeze frame will use the keyframes of the null object. Okay, the only thing that is bothering me now are the tracking marks that are still in the shot, but you can easily remove them with this simple trick. Duplicate the shot with the tracking marks above the original. Then take the rectangle masking tool and draw a mask next to the tracking mark. This will give you a smaller portion of the doorpost. Move this over the tracking mark so that it is removed. Now go to your layer and freeze frame it, otherwise the image inside your mask will constantly change. After this, go to the Parent Pick Whip tool and parent it to the null object. If done correctly, you'll now have a removed tracking mark. Do exactly the same for the other one. As a last detail, and if necessary, you can enable the animation for the position and the scale on the freeze frame clip. Adjust these properties of the clip when moving further in time to keep the ground of the freeze clip from moving strangely. And that was it for one transition. Now you can add as many as you want. It works completely the same for the rest of the transitions. And that was it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Oh, man.